man, it is time. It is time for the Final Fantasy 16 sweepstakes here at Easy Allies. Who will win? Who will be in charge? Will we see Final Fantasy 16? And, you know, will we get a shadow-dropped demo? Sorry, before we went live, everyone, we're Easy Allies. We're reacting to Final Fantasy 16. Maybe. Who knows? PlayStation 5 showcase will be happening. Before we even went live, we had a wonderful chat, the eight of us, about Final Fantasy 16 for about 10 minutes. And I've gone loony. I've had enough of Final Fantasy 16. I want out. I want off this train. Let us know if it's happening or not. It should be the first thing they do. Say it's not here or just show it because holy crap. Wow.
Go cuckoo, Damiani.
Yeah. We completely convinced ourselves that Final Fantasy 16 is happening based on nothing.
We had so many crazy theories. Based on a typo. The typo has confirmed it.
Not a trailer. The full shadow drop will happen.
I will adjust levels and everything in just a second, chat. However, we are just a little over 10 minutes away. I do need to take a research break. I'm sorry. It's embarrassing. As soon as I hit the go live button, it hit. And I was like, I got to sit through 2 minutes of a song now and then take us live and then deal with this. So I was like, great timing, world. But what else besides Final Fantasy 16 do you think we're going to see there while I step away for a second real quick?
Demon Souls.
Definitely Final Fantasy 16 2. I'm
going to tease that. Yes, the Final Fantasy 16 trilogy, of course.
Right.
But no.
The Silent Hill shirt in front of the Demon Souls background?
Correct.
Okay. Hey, I didn't say Bloodborne. I recognize it was Demon Souls.
Where did you get that
shirt? I want to buy that shirt.
Very nice. I mean, I think Demon's Souls gameplay hopefully will be there. Miles Morales gameplay.
Miles Morales should be there. Hold that for please.
Price and a freaking date finally should be there.
Yeah, gotta be here.
Yeah.
Red Dead Redemption 2.
I did see the mystery maker.
Port? It's gonna be there.
I can see that.
Yeah.
Oh, Rockstar starts it again.
Good one, yep.
Yep.
The Rockstar logo 5? Gets shown before the PlayStation logo.
Yo, God of War reveal, man.
Yeah, let's go, dude. I'm on the train with Huber now. Let's go, Huber.
Launch title.
Good chance of that.
Safe to say Horizon's skipping it because they were there last time. Horizon's just like, whew, all right, back to
They're going
to
show it. You know? They're going to milk that garbage.
They might have a little tease at everything they've already shown, even if it's not.
I think we're
going to
get a Horizon 2 demo on Steam for sure.
The Steam demos today are gonna
Steam demos, yeah.
Could be hard to follow.
Yeah, Ian's
my other mic didn't work right now. I just moved my PC into my bedroom, so I'm using my headset right now.
Ian,
so
we now go to the Ian Hank traffic cam. Ian, how's it look up there?
Looks like Boletaria.
PlayStation 5 Showcase is an extremely vague title. They could just talk about the console for an hour and be like, we told you. And we're like, well, I guess
they said a bunch of games. First and like, party, 40 minutes.
10 minutes.
They said some expectations.
Unedited Demon Souls gameplay, man.
Did they say a bunch? Sick. Was that the actual parlance?
I don't think bunch was used.
Okay.
A game a minute, Jones. That's what they said. 40 minutes.
That's more than a bunch.
Yeah.
That's a cavalcade.
Wow.
A bunch is like six. You can hold a bunch in one hand.
What do you think the chances are of them actually giving us like a solid launch lineup would be? I want to see that.
I think there's a high chance.
I want to know like what games is Sony going to guarantee will be there day one with the console?
They have waited for this moment.
What will the total runtime of pointless console CG graphics be at the end of this? Like, if we added it all up, will it break 1 minute of airtime?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It'll break a minute.
Over 3 minutes.
Do you count raw elements becoming the PlayStation 5? It's not the PS5 yet, but it's bubbling.
No, that's what I'm talking
about. I mean, I would
like,
count the thing that's on the screen right now if the show is starting.
Garbage.
Right. What is the chance of a claymation presentation happening where they use clay to build the PlayStation 5? Like clay.
I mean, you kind of do, right? When you mock up, when they make the very earliest prototypes?
I would kill to have the money to do a promo where it's literally like T-1000 just steel, just like molds up into like bread. You know, like,
sweet.
Like all of us just went by one. People were like, whoa.
But actually,
this is
four, and
we're like, no, they just made it. It's not
game announcements aside, I kind of would like that. Maybe not in this showcase, but I kind of would like to see something like the evolution of like all of the design process on the console, like the different throwaway ideas.
But you bring up a good point, Blood, which is like, I think it's really rare that we'll get like, in November, you will be playing this. Like, I think it'll be like, on the PlayStation, in the foreseeable future, here's the party we're going to have. Like, because that way they can put more stuff into it. So like, specifically policing themselves enough to be like, no, we need to tell consumers what they're getting. I would be elated, because even Microsoft hasn't really done that. You know, like we know they've talked about it, but like they've never done a montage or a video that's like this and this and this and this and this is what you'll be looking at when you're holding that box at, you know, Best Buy or whatever.
I feel the next gen hype right now. Like I woke up feeling like a kid, and you know, maybe I'll be disappointed, but I think just being able to be excited at the possibility is awesome.
Hell yeah, dude. And a Final Fantasy 16.
did I go away and tell you to talk about something other than 16?
We did. Yeah. We did. Don't okay. worry.
Okay.
Huber just brought it back. Well, dude, Huber, I was like 0% last night, and Ben comes in hot, being like, oh man, can't wait to see it. Can't wait to say 16. Yeah.
The Huber internal like rev engine. Shit. 0 to 99.
Do we want to
you're redlining?
Do we
want to
put
right now,
our chips down on these prices?
500,
450, and 500.
450
for both.
Yeah, I agree with
500.
That.
That's
where my chips. I'm gonna go with that. I'm gonna go with that optimistic low end at 450 and 400.
Ooh, I like that too. That's
what I can easily be right.
I've got something crazy on this one. Can you hear me? Hopefully,
is yes. Last. Yeah.
Yeah.
600. I'm gonna say, not to bring anyone down, only to take the edge off. Okay, let's let go right now. If they announce it at 600, we're just like, all right, cool, at 600. That's the reality.
I'm fine. It's yeah, either way. Never,
not since the PS3 have we seen a design this ornate, this garish, you could say, Jones, right? It just makes me feel like this thing is a you don't want to put this in your backpack and take it to your friend's house. It's a museum.
It's an art
piece.
Tax.
Yeah.
You know, the
it's,
arc,
a design,
yeah.
It's a design.
It's
tax.
Not moving. Yeah,
such a good point. Know, one of them's just a boring box, and the other one is, you know, people are gonna, my family's gonna comment on that.
Those folded lips.
You have any conversations you get to open up just because of, you know, the you know, it increases property value. It just, you know, it's a showpiece.
You imagine the cost of the molds to make those those right? slaps.
They're looking at earlier models, they're like curvier.
Well, that too,
can
and when
you,
they
pulled out more, and like
when they just did the story about the chip shortage, and now this many thousands of units less, I think that's part of what they're playing into of like why we haven't found out yet, because everyone that's on board is 100% on board, and if it ends up being six, we just, you know, they're gonna bite the bullet. I think now that they know the units of feeding frenzy.
Welcome back.
You saw they denied that, right, Don? They ended up saying like, oh no, that
the shortage
didn't happen. Yeah, the shortage.
Yeah, that's hard to say what,
so
what to
weird.
Make of that. So.
Denied.
4 minutes.
Weird.
Real quick, Don.
Will we
you,
be able to pre-order
a
PlayStation
a
5 successfully? That's the real question.
And there's no way it's going to be at the end of the show, right? They even said they would give notice. I need to have like my
for the
Amazon open,
oh,
ready
no.
everyone
run to the internet.
No, yeah. Wasn't the rumor that it'll start later though?
Yeah. Give a date for the pre-orders at least.
So, Elden Ring's going to be sick, right? When they show it.
Yeah,
it's gonna look real good, dude.
Yeah,
like, that's a good way to. That'll be a great way to end this thing. I'm excited for that.
I'm gonna freak out, dude. If they show like, Elden Ring,
there's gonna be like this kind of bizarre, out of place hype man, and he's gonna like, we're gonna see Final Fantasy 16. He's gonna be like, wow, they can't get any better than this, and then just goes right into Elden Ring.
And what if Elden Ring is Final Fantasy 16?
Yeah,
whoa,
I wouldn't be surprised.
Same universe.
Same universe.
I really want to see factions.
Entries have had stranger journeys to Final Fantasy Dumb.
Really hoping for factions.
We were trying to get Ian hyped on Final Fantasy earlier, and his tactics, you know.
Dude, tactics.
Yeah, unless it's tactics, I'm probably not going to care. Sorry.
Anything is possible. In the Anything it's crazy possible. In the trailer they're gonna go even Ian will be convinced like
even Ian will call you out
Oculus announced a new headset today. Do you think we'll see anything in regards to how PlayStation 5 interacts with PSVR or a new PSVR headset? Or what do you think on those lines?
Village showcase.
I sure hope not.
I think that probably might be separate.
I wouldn't believe it because I would only announce it right now if it's coming out with the PS5. Like if it's not something I can buy in 2020, it's like why are we even talking about this right now?
Sure.
I just confuse consumers, I think.
I just want to say I would actually like more PSVR. I was just playing VR a little bit of Iron Man VR, and I don't know. I think there's enough potential there that I'd really love to see it continue.
Same. Personally.
It'd be neat if they, not new hardware, but if they announced a bunch of stuff like that. If Alex was coming to PSVR or something. Yeah. If they had some fun
That'd be cool. Yeah.
That's a
cool idea, Brandon.
Even if it was next year,
I would really like to see, you know, future looks bright. If there's any more that they can actually do with PSVR that, you know, they're limited to right now with the PS4 hardware, even with the same headset, you know, if they can bump some things up. So even games that you already have run better.
I wonder if probably frame rate more than
I am excited for the Mist thing. And yes, I'm using my headset microphone. I'm sorry.
1 minute to go.
Oh, we got to stay tuned.
Stay tuned. Huber.
Ned.
Chance. No. Percentage chance. Anything Kratos showing up in this showcase?
90%. 90%. Even if it's the 2018 God of War.
Gotcha. Yeah.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah, I think
they said over 100 backwards compatible games or something. They were like 100 first party, 100 of the best PS4 games. I expect to see some of those, and I absolutely expect God of War to be one of those.
Oh yeah, they'll totally do a montage of all of them running on PlayStation 5. I mean, it'll literally be a montage. It'll be like, look how good it looks. It's like, I don't know, dude.
Do you think there'll be any push or change or improvement to PlayStation Now with Game Pass getting so much buzz?
I would really like that.
Yeah, maybe.
They need a reinvention of that marketing on that, because I feel like nobody cares about PlayStation Now.
Older titles being downloadable with PlayStation Now would be nice. Yeah.
Especially because one of the PS,
because it's kind of loud.
Especially because one of the PS5s is all digital, so like that stuff's even more important now.
Yeah.
Now. Totally. Yeah, that's a good point, Huber.
Classic late Sony.
And I don't want to make the music too loud just yet, so I don't know.
I like this music though.
That's a good. Cranking it up, chat. Here we go.
May contain a content inappropriate for children. Silent Hill confirmed. Silent Hill confirmed.
AK60, let's go.
That's it. That's the message.
I think this is the PS5.
Could unmute it, probably.
Oh yeah, I remember that one game.
Each time I awake,
Thea.
This planet seems somehow different.
Yeah, they're like showing everything that was in the last.
See things others can't.
What's the little girl asking?
This is the power that flows through this
land. I don't remember the name of it.
Yet you do know.
Yeah, this is like a recap of last time.
Yeah.
Previously on PlayStation 5 Showcase.
Pragmata?
I will be ready.
Pragmata. Thanks.
Why did we forget that?
Let's do this.
Music, dude.
Video games.
We talked about Godfall
different
at all. At all, we didn't talk about
it.
Godfall.
Oh, yeah. What? Yeah.
Brutal. All the work they've done.
PC emulating the PS5 experience.
Oh, no, Steam demos. Okay. Get ready.
So, third party.
Steam demos, man.
Weird thing to want to start with.
Steam demo.
Whoa.
It's Final Fantasy.
Oh.
This looks like the most Final Fantasy face.
That looks like the protagonist from Final Fantasy 14.
That is a Final Fantasy protagonist right there. Only
the Dragon's Dogma, maybe?
Wait.
How do we even know that this is Final Fantasy?
Yeah.
100%.
Do not question orders.
Yep.
Those
100%.
Are
chocobos.
Oh shit!
And you all doubted. You all doubted. Summon their
icon.
Oh shit, Titan?
That
picked a bloody mountain.
There you go.
Unit 3!
Dude, that looks like...
Out the gate!
Dude.
Holy crap.
That rock crush,
like,
dude.
That looks like, what's her face from 15? Dogs. This will
be a bit of a man, dude.
Wait, is this Ivalice? You should not be
out of doors. The style is so familiar.
Yeah.
It's very 14 and 11.
It's fantasy again.
I actually kind of get like a Final Fantasy 3 vibe.
Yeah, I was thinking that too, Ben. Shield.
I'm sworn to protect. Yo, I guess have the different colored chocobos.
Oh, it's a
time combat!
Yeah!
Wow.
Much pausing though in the combat.
There's a lot of people saying to turn the stream up, Damiani.
Okay.
Yes.
What does it matter? Oh, it's more like Dalmec Cry, actually.
It was the Dalmex who drove back the Crusaders in the Battle of the Twin Realms, was it not?
Without the blessing of the Mother Crystal, we cannot defend our realm from the spread of the Blight.
The Mother Crystal.
That's. I mean, that's what the Dragoon, baby! Let's go!
Yeah! Yeah. How do you know?
Hell yeah, dude!
So, I sent in the Dragoons. Imperial Vipers. Do they really mean to invade us?
Coral, baby, let's go.
Wow, there's a ton
of story in this trailer, man.
Oh!
Holy
blood.
Shit!
Blooded!
Fantasy based on reality.
Yeah.
Phoenix. Yo, that was a big try.
Fizz?
Yeah.
That was the buster right there.
Wait.
Fire boy.
Second life on the fire. But that's impossible.
Freed?
Yeah.
Wait, so humans can. This is 14 shit. Humans summoning primals as vessels? The legacy of the crystals.
What if this isn't 16?
This is 16.
I mean,
it's totally 16,
it
but I mean.
Yeah, yeah.
They're borrowing a lot of cool shit from different games here.
Dude.
If it's the last thing
Yikes, man, what'd I do?
You know what you did.
I'm buying two PS5s for this shit.
I'm hyped on this, man.
Wow. They got in.
Immediate turn.
The impossible.
There we go.
Also available on PC. Xbox fans are crying right now.
Oh my god.
Throat was slit right there.
Bye, X-Men.
Oh, dude. My.
Jeez.
I'd be okay with, like, closing the stream. Like, I'm good now.
Yeah, it's over. It. It's like, bye. Thanks for watching.
Everything that comes now is a bonus.
Yeah, it's a bonus. Gravy, everything gravy that comes now is a bonus.
Yep. I still think that the console exclusive is just, there's just going to be, like, Final Fantasy 16, like, Phoenix Edition or something.
Final Fantasy 7?
All of it.
Dude, I like this Sherlock Holmes. Like,
okay, everything else is from a PlayStation 5.
Yeah. Spider-Man? Yep.
Spider-Man.
Oh, Spider-Man. Yeah. Damn it. Trying to tease me there.
I'm late for mom's rally.
Subway card. Check. You got the house key?
Yeah, I got it.
So jolly.
Yeah, dude. Vibes already.
Come on! We're gonna be late! Hey! Dude, I am so filling your suit with snow. Are you still wearing your suit?
Yeah, you know, just in case.
It's gonna be fine. See, this is my favorite part of living in Harlem. Pop-up street fair, best food in the city, awesome music.
So many people.
Man, this would be great for the last 8 hours.
Best Christmas game.
I should get back into mixing.
Yeah, good call.
It's been a while.
Some hot cocoa.
Yeah.
Playing some Spider-Man. Sounds good.
You gonna vote for her?
That's what I was thinking for Ratchet and Clank.
Hard to think
like,
Mom is a politician. She's been a teacher my whole life. Similar skill sets, right? Corralling people, educating them, making sure they don't throw things at each other.
Feast, that's Aunt May's place.
Yeah. Notice that.
Hi, I'm Brian Horton, creative director at Insomniac Games. We're excited to show you this first look at gameplay from Marvel Spider-Man Miles Morales. Our story picks up 1 year after the events of the first game, and we find Miles' new home,
Harlem,
is in danger. Trouble brews while Miles' mom, Rio Morales, leads an election rally, a war between the devious energy corporation Roxxon and the Underground. A high-tech criminal army led by the Tinkerer starts to break out. In this gameplay sequence, captured on PlayStation 5 hardware, the Underground attacks Roxxon, sending the rally into chaos in a fight that spills onto the Braithwaite Bridge, where the Underground tries to steal Roxxon's experimental energy source, Nuform. Let's take a look.
Go, go, go! Stop!
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Let's not shoot each other, all right?
It's funny how watching this just immediately makes me think less of Avengers.
Oh.
It all starts.
No, this is a multiplayer. Oh. So.
Tinkerers.
We're after the new form.
Although multiplayer would be a fun thing to learn today. Co-op action.
Tinkerers in Homecoming, it's Tombs is right
there. Get rid of him. Then grab as much as you can carry.
Yeah.
Enhance those powers.
Give me that yellow AoE.
Oh boy.
Classic Spider-Man bridge scenario here.
Mm-hmm. Keep him busy.
People up the whole truck!
Whoa.
That bridge is coming down! I have to stop this!
Goons with medium length hair. I don't know if I've ever seen that before.
This looks so sick.
Yeah, this just looks fun.
Yeah, this
is... Oh, whoa. Yo, they stole this from Soul Calibur, man.
Yo!
Disability, yeah.
Yeah, that's actually a little bit.
It's cool to bounce off that car.
Help! Help!
What's interesting in like...
No.
Maybe I'm like hardly imagining this, but I feel like I'm hearing more spatial audio than I do. Oops. Like I can tell that a voice is coming from behind you.
No, 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 no!
The bus!
Man, this is crazy.
Yeah.
Everybody get out!
It's cool, not really a quick time, that's actually like your ability, you gotta aim.
Yeah.
Knocking out!
Oh,
I got you!
Oh! That was sick.
Thank you, man. I was thinking, like, what if he just dies?
I've got an idea.
Classic Spider-Man.
Yep. Does he miss one?
I can stop this!
I don't know about this.
Yo, Spider-Man 2 here.
Yeah.
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 100%.
Oh!
Oh no.
Newsin'.
Holiday. Crazy. Yeah, no dates out yet.
No date, yeah.
Yeah, no date. Wow.
That'll probably be a pretty good game, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like how they showed both the action sequence and the environmental storytelling.
Cody's heating up.
Cody's heating up right there, dude.
Well, that's... and they had like, you know, like solid combat, like actual gameplay, too.
All right, so Silent Hill next,
right? Yeah, what's Huber?
Huber? Like, holy shit.
Check off the boxes.
What?
Out of control.
Huber.
Right. Oh, Harry Potter's? Hey, they finally are showing it.
Bad timing.
Yeah, didn't even think about
bad timing.
This
both beautiful and
powerful binds together our long. We gotta take whatever from this franchise, whatever we can, while we
that
can.
That common bond we share is the legacy of Hogwarts.
That's Jim Dale.
A legacy.
That's Jim Dale. It's the guy that does the audio. Now it is time to books.
Add late 1800s
to these hallowed halls.
This is kind of cool. He's in the game, actually.
Shape the future of the wizarding world.
What if he narrates it like a fable?
Oh, that'd be amazing. He does the portrait, the U.S. version.
Every stone in this castle tells the story. Witches and wizards who came before. Here you will meet lifelong friends and grow into your own magical abilities in the classrooms of the world's most
human animations professors. Look a little janky.
And while your journey begins at Hogwarts, brewing potions, taming fantastic beasts, and mastering spells, there is a larger world beyond these walls. A world filled with dangers you can't yet imagine. An ancient knowledge long gone from this world. That strange and mysterious talent you possess may be the key to unlocking this dormant power. Your potential limitless.
Yeah.
But what form will it take? The journey ahead will reveal what you stand for.
Interesting line.
Yeah. And no sound effects in this trailer at all.
The choices you make now will define the legacy of Hogwarts.
Hogwarts Legacy.
Portkey Games.
2021.
Right.
Portkey Games, didn't they do the mobile game? I don't know.
Do not know.
Bad fuck JK Rowling, though.
Yeah, pretty hard to be excited about that.
Yeah, I'm not giving that franchise a dime ever.
It is ill-timed.
Hi everyone, Silence is Derek, creative director at Raven. One of our goals as developers is to bring
Raven
the game world
software
to life unlike anything you've ever experienced,
Raven software
and the PlayStation 5 is making
that
happen.
Things that they've done.
With the power of the new console, we've been able to significantly enhance the overall experience. From what you see in the world, how it feels in your hands, to what you hear around
Please
you.
Make a new Jedi Outcast.
In Black Ops Cold War, you will be transported to the year 1981, in the middle of one of the most dangerous times the world has ever known, the height of the Cold War. The following is a portion of the first campaign mission where you've been given the name of a high-value target linked to the Iran hostage crisis. But in true Black Ops style, nothing is as it seems. Take a look.
Kasim is out of the picture.
How long before we get Arash?
The team arrived in Turkey a few hours ago. They should be in position shortly.
airfield's just up ahead. Let's go.
I thought
find
that was Carl Urban
head.
For a second. I was like, the boys?
One side.
Priority.
Why did he just shoot the car?
He didn't, let's go. Hard. He didn't say the C word, so it's not Carl Urban.
Yeah.
Lots of gameplay in this so far. I'm enjoying it. Mm-hmm. Just show us what the console can do.
I always love the Black Ops vibe.
Check it out.
Totally, man. Campaigns.
Oh, yeah.
The story is like
probably the first one's still my
legit
favorite COD
good.
Story.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably my favorite COD campaigns with the Black Ops ones.
Incoming truck. Left side.
Or one and two, at least, I guess I should say. Clarify.
I'd say because it has good characters. Black Ops 1 and 2. You like care about the main characters, you know?
Yeah, and it leans into the goofy in a really fun way.
Totally.
I can't make out his face yet.
Modern Warfare can just be so plot driven.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good point, dude. I agree.
Just iced everyone in a truck.
Shit.
That's gotta be a rush.
They shoot their drivers.
We need a positive ID. That's our man. Take him out.
Sniper elite over here.
Nice.
Get! We missed him! Can't let him get away!
You have to miss?
Took the shot immediately.
Yeah.
Like, no matter what you do, you miss, or maybe this is like a thing.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
kind of weird.
Maybe this is the way like the campaign's progressing.
I thought he was
actually,
sticking a grenade in his mouth.
There, I did hear that there are different endings for this game.
Yeah.
They spoke to that, yeah, so I wonder. He did take
they
the shot pretty quick.
Around with that in Black Ops 2 a little bit, like mission choices and stuff.
It was a little hasty with that shot. Then this is very standard. So it's like,
yeah,
this is what happened.
God damn it!
This
music, dude.
We're not done yet! Or maybe chasing.
Yeah. I really like that gun kickback. That's.
Man, RC Prime looks really good.
Yeah, I know.
It's like a standalone RC.
Sweet.
Game.
Oh, that looked like it went through his head.
Right.
What?
God, okay.
Shit.
Some red text snuck in there at the end. I wonder what that was.
We hope you enjoyed that sneak peek at the campaign for Black Ops Cold War. There are many more twists and turns along the way as you begin to unravel the truth, and we can't wait for you to play it soon. In addition to the story campaign, Cold War features the next generation of multiplayer online combat and an all-new awesome zombies experience. Today, I have the special honor to announce on behalf of my friends at Treyarch that the PlayStation community doesn't have to wait to play multiplayer. Starting this Friday,
Ooh.
PlayStation players will be able to play the multiplayer alpha exclusively on PlayStation 4. And for those of you that are watching at home on your PS4, you can preload the experience starting tomorrow.
Wow. Okay.
We can't wait to see you online Friday and through the weekend. Enjoy the rest of the show.
He removed Mario.
What?
Mario v. COD this weekend. It's going to be a good fight.
Mario v. COD.
At last. The Titans.
This feels like price reveal music.
This is like Fall Guys level.
They're clearly going to reveal the price at the end, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
These long pauses are killing me.
Yeah.
All clear. Resident Evil.
Yeah,
sure.
RE8. There's Chris.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
There's Chris. What the hell?
Oh.
Take him away.
Gandalf too.
My soul feels full.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is hit after hit.
In life and in death, we give glory. The bell tolls for us all. They're coming again!
Mia.
Quit being so paranoid.
What? I played already, son. Mia, what are you talking about?
A young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work.
Oh, interesting.
But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence. The bushes empty.
Become a werewolf for sure. Look at that walk.
Yet determined to find the berries, the rest of broke free of Mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine, under branch, and into the forest deep. It's just a local tale.
Okay.
Village Resident Evil.
That music reminded me of Resident Evil 1.
Oh.
That, if it's just looking, window shop away.
The penguin?
Wait, was that the merchant?
That was a new merchant, dude.
New merchant, yeah.
Oh, new merchant,
100%. That was a new merchant, dude.
The penguin's the merchant.
Yeah.
You want out of a time loop? You gotta learn how it works. Black Reef is a puzzle.
Okay.
And each visionary is a.
Those enemies
piece.
Remind me of We Happy Few.
Yeah.
Yeah,
here's Eagle.
Mm-hmm. I am a respected scientist!
I've done so many loops, I've learned to run circles around him.
Yeah. Love it.
Yeah. I am trying to focus, you son of a bitch!
Classic yell.
I've tried taking my targets out one by one more than I can remember, but there is never enough time. I go after one, another lives. Because right now, half an island away, a different visionary is throwing his nightly cannibal masquerade. Alexis Dorsey.
Everybody shut up!
This is my jam.
Igor's a big fan, yet somehow he never makes it to the party. Something keeps him home.
Colt, you there, buddy?
Here's the invite to the party. And here's why Igor blew it off. He made some kind of scientific breakthrough that morning.
I did it, it works!
That he makes every morning, unless I get there first.
Before you load that gun.
No experiment, no breakthrough, no reason for Igor not to drink his disappointment with Alexis. Now I got a shot at killing them both at the same time.
Huh.
In the same loop.
Huh.
That's awesome.
Bust it! Is that
man, I wonder how many different things you can set up like that.
Yeah.
Right?
Like, can you get all eight at this party?
Come out, Blake!
or is that your only option with that guy? It's like, yeah, you're at his base of the party, he comes out, or send him somewhere else.
A little help here!
The loop is gnarly.
Eight targets on my list. Every one of them with grand plans for eternal life.
I feel like sexy brutal vibes.
I gotta break the
loop. I mean, obviously, wait for the king.
Clock's ticking.
And you just ran out of time. You keep forgetting, Colt. I'm not like those other idiots. Only got one name on my list. Yours.
Man.
Hell yeah.
The loop.
Looks well, too.
So excited for that game.
I like that they had a trailer that didn't need to focus on her, you know?
Oh, console exclusive?
Did we know
exclusive.
That? I forget.
I don't think I knew that, but maybe.
That was on my fantasy team. Don't That's out.
Stranger Things?
This is the logo music.
That was the music that tricked me. I thought it was Genova.
20 first. Seconds of interstitial.
Genova, dude. Tell me how you write
Capcom.
It.
Capcom.
I'm nervous.
Modern, though. Positions were
switched. Oh, it's Devil May Cry.
Special edition or whatever?
Would I have your life?
Virgil! They're doing it! They're doing Virgil!
Yeah.
You a demon.
Oh, hell yeah!
There it is.
Next gen. Oh my god, this is show getting free. Kneel before me. This is power.
I think I expanded the co-op.
Oh shit!
Whoa!
You can summon me!
Whoa, dude!
Oh my god!
Rest in peace.
Let's go!
Devil May Cry.
At launch, baby! Yeah!
Oh, yeah.
Oh fuck yeah!
That's only digitally though. Seems like that's sick, Ben.
No physical guarantees being made by this company.
Uh-huh. Oh, sure. Just shipping and stuff.
Were there any new cutscenes in there, Ben? Some of that stuff I didn't recognize.
I think.
Oddworld. All
right, sure. Maybe the Lady and Trish stuff. But I'd have
what if that song was new? Did you recognize the song, Ben?
That was probably his new theme. Doing?
Yeah.
Virgil.
Did those fugitive morons burn down their own hideout?
It sounds idiotic, but that's exactly what it looks like.
Bad Quama for burning down my farm.
Hi, I'm Lorne Lanning, creative director of Oddworld Soulstorm. And we're excited to bring you an all-new exclusive trailer from the game. Here, our unlikely hero, Abe, finds himself fresh off the back of freeing his people from the nefarious Rupture Farms. He thinks the journey is over, but soon discovers it has only just begun. The stakes are higher, the threats are larger, the obstacles are more devious, and it's all made possible by the power of PlayStation 5. Enjoy.
The tone of this is all over.
Yeah.
Oddworld.
It's definitely got a strange tone to it.
folder.
Guy, get away from us again!
I totally see what you're saying, but man, I don't know. I'm a little dark.
Yeah, it's dark.
Wait here.
Hey, why the hold up?
I could go for a sandwich right now.
We gotta get out of here.
Order for some lunch.
Get out of here.
My tummy's growling. I'm hungry.
No, it's a comedy.
That's what I mean. It's like, it's a weird.
A cutscene or something? Oh, that was it. Okay. It sounded like he was kind of describing a cutscene, like a story moment.
Mm. That makes me think of Control.
It's just they get a new environment and then they're like, let's make a big action thing, and it's like, you're just, yeah, they're selling that game the wrong way a little bit.
Hmm.
Gregory,
it's not epic quite in that way.
Worried about you. They're here with me. Please come out.
Is this
I may have lost my temper earlier, but it was just a glitch.
Yeah, my first thought was...
It won't happen again.
Whoa. Like, Five Nights at Freddy's or something?
For all of us. Why don't you come out and we can play a game together?
Oh my god, wait, is it?
It won't happen again.
Yeah, it is.
It is,
oh my
yeah,
god.
Yeah. You can see. Yeah. I don't know anything about Five Nights.
It's just right.
Gregory,
usually not sold this way. Still, that's one thing, at least.
I think she's found us.
Looks like you can walk around.
Of course.
Yeah.
Interesting that it's in the showcase.
Security breach!
Okay.
Okay. Alright. Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay.
In a next gen showcase.
I'm so out of the loop of that series, like I have no idea.
I mean,
if
they're
that's exciting or not.
Like, they're really popular just, with like
it
teens,
looked really good.
Young,
you're just shutting shit. Doors and checking cams, man. It's just all about where you're looking and what buttons you're pressing.
Jump scare city.
Yep.
Yep.
Oh shit.
Uh oh.
Demon
yes,
Souls.
Yes, Demon
Souls.
Souls.
It's the Nexus, dude.
Yeah,
yep.
It's the Nexus.
I remember that line, bud. Oh, yeah, we all do.
Best hub person.
Oh, yeah.
Show me that Earthstone repaired.
Oh, my God, if they do, dude.
Oh, dude.
Come on. Keep panning.
Yeah. Oh, my God, that would be insane.
They're always facing the camera away from it.
God damn, it looks gorgeous.
Yum.
Right. Oh, I couldn't tell.
Yeah, we gotta pause that shot.
Oh, yes, dude. Oh.
Here we go.
Dude, I can't even.
Oh, it's perfect.
God. I can't.
That's a good looking game.
Ship it.
That's a pretty game.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. This is insane already, dude.
I love it. And he's just fighting like scrubs.
Oh, yeah. He's just doing the tutorial area.
Yeah.
There's your signs.
Yeah, I'm with you, Blood. Am I tripping with the sound? I don't know. It's like. I guess it just sounds good. Maybe I'm thinking too much into it, but it.
No, I think it might have something to do with.
It just
you know,
just
how
his feet
the
going through the water
stuff.
And the stone. It sounded like it had a little more volume to it, but it's.
Oh no! Nice.
Gonna be an expensive
parry. Oh, did he man. Parry a shield dash?
The shield's doing work.
Oh,
a little like.
This looks
sword block there.
So perfect.
Yeah. Seems like his damage output is high.
There's like,
maybe.
There's like a little bit of clipping, but everything else looks so. Mm.
Yeah, yeah. It's a Souls game.
Yeah.
Is everything dying in one hit because maybe it's also teasing an easy mode?
Shut up, Damiani. No.
Yeah, he just.
I mean, maybe he's took just care over-leveled.
Of that guy. Took care yeah, of this guy's guy. Way over-leveled.
Wow, that lighting is just fantastic.
Wait. Like deep down,
I mean, to be fair, if it was taking like several hits for every enemy, he wouldn't would be here yet. Yeah, it would take forever for the demo.
All right, here we go.
Wow. I love this no narration. Yeah. He's just rolling right into it.
Really good.
Got about one more hit.
Oh, the music.
Look at the blood splatter on the boss.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
You died.
So good.
Nice. Yes. Show me more.
Oh, this area is so cool.
Whoa. Oh, man.
Man, that area in particular.
Oh, I must have saw.
Oh. Wow. Even just going back and forth between those areas, like,
oh my god,
that looks great.
Gotta be launch.
Dude, launch, please.
Oh, no answer.
No information.
You bastard.
This looks so ready.
God, it looks yeah. so go. Good.
Sometime.
Yeah.
I think DMC 5 is the only thing they specifically said at launch.
And that's enough.
Yeah.
Fortnite.
Yeah.
We're dropping boys.
Oh. Racing. Yeah. Available at launch?
Sweet.
Glad that available. Was short. You don't need any
yeah,
more.
Yeah. Ask. Hi.
Yeah.
I'm here to talk to you about Fortnite for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
PlayStation Plus collection.
What? Gonna be all the remastered 100, top 100 games.
Wow.
Don, that's a great guess.
The shape
is this the game pass?
They changed.
They're ooh, yellow
new
now.
Benefit. New benefit.
Uh-oh, Game Pass. You're right.
You there it is.
Bloodborne, baby.
There's Bloodborne, yeah. Monster World.
They're all here. Just get them all forever.
My name is Marcus.
My name is Kara.
My name is Connor.
The My Name My Talk.
Yeah, what is everybody else's name? Now I want to know.
Oh man, Last Guardian on PS5? Nice.
After all we've been through.
Yeah, these are all three when it comes out. But...
I think that's where we're going.
It's yeah, time. I think so.
Yeah, not Royal, just the older one. Yeah. I think that's how they're doing it.
Yep. Download it. Start playing.
Cool.
That's pretty awesome.
That is. What is I need to see the benefits.
Bloodborne.
See the
day
improvements.
One, dude.
This is a clapback.
Boost mode.
Yeah, I definitely want more details on how that works. It sounds like it just comes with the PS Plus.
Yeah, that's what I would assume based
seeing
on
all the shapes now.
Yeah, is this the
is the reveal of Prisei? Huh?
The longest pauses I've ever
there
seen.
You go. Yeah, it's a little
indulgent.
Yeah.
Where is my mind?
US dollars.
Yeah, you're right, Blood.
Loosen up your purse strings, everybody.
600 for Dawn.
Not claymation.
I like that texture in there.
It's gonna collect so much dust. Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm only touching the same with gloves. 500.
$499.
Wow.
Wow.
November.
November 12th.
Whoa. Staggering.
2 days after Xbox.
Yep.
I'm gonna buy the digital one.
So now you know.
Yeah. What's the other than a drive?
Thank you all for joining us.
Yeah. Is that a $100 Blu-ray drive? Is that it?
Amazing gem.
That's insane.
It's your passion as fans of gaming that drives us to deliver a truly new generation of experiences on PS5. From everyone at PlayStation, we appreciate your continued support, and we look forward to you getting your hands on PS5 very soon. To close, let me leave you with one more quick look.
Oh no.
Bastard,
what? Check a look.
What is it?
Break what
those.
Is nervous?
Break those.
It's gotta be something massive.
It could be God.
Yeah, it has to be.
Seems
mm-hmm.
like.
Mm-hmm.
Oh shit.
God of
War.
Oh, it is, dude.
God of War.
Yeah.
Ragnarok.
I was joking.
Holy shit, dude.
At launch.
Yeah, right.
It is.
Who reads runes?
It's Ragnarok. It reads Ragnarok. Yeah.
Yourself.
Yeah. Just called Rag.
Sick.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa,
dude.
Whoa, right. Dude. All right. What?
Alright.
Dude, damn. 2021.
It'd be sick if, like, a slightly older, you could, like, hear an older voice be like, I will. Like,
oh. Pretty confident flashing that date.
Yeah, not a lot of confidence in chat right now.
Oh, yeah, no.
Montage. Oh, my God.
You're
going to put this song in.
Oh, I can
hear
it.
Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah. But.
It's too late. Long.
Yeah, it is too late.
Tales of Arise.
Yeah, oh. Huber, is that like childhood narration, that like storybook? I wonder if that's going to be all the way through 8.
No,
like, she's not there, and you don't know what happened, but he keeps recalling the last time he saw her, the story she told.
Tam Tam.
I love
Tam
that.
Tam Tam, baby.
Hey, Godfall.
That Godfall.
Yeah. The amount of time it's necessary. Bad. I'm surprised they didn't go back at the end and give everything actual dates.
Right.
Instead of like holiday or whatever.
Yeah. Maybe it's going to be a press release. They'll have all the dates.
Oh, yeah.
For some
check
of them,
your email. Blood.
It's a little weird they just didn't put them in there, but sure.
We eaten.
Oh, my gosh. Well, that was your PlayStation 5 showcase. That makes it time for the PlayStation 5 Showcased post show here. We have a lot to talk about. I gotta go grab some trailers because holy we gotta rewatch some stuff.
I got a question. Holy crap. That does not involve B-roll to kick off the conversation. Why am I spending $500 on this? Why would I do that? Somebody tacked me down off the ledge. Spending $400 on this console.
Probably for backwards compatibility if you want, or if you want 4K Blu-rays have like physical movies.
Yeah, it's like, do you want physical?
So good.
But a Blu-ray drive doesn't cost $100.
It might. I mean,
dude, a 4K Blu-ray is expensive.
Yeah. I mean, the 4K Blu-ray is like $250. Just like,
if they want to encourage people to go digital, like they could take more of a loss on that digital.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
On the off chance we get sent a game for coverage and it's disc only, like
that's the main thing.
Of course. You nailed it. Yeah. That's it. That's what I was looking for, Ben. Yep.
So
we get lonely, baby. You know, a fair number of discs still.
Yep.
This Final Fantasy 16 trailer has a title. It's called Awakening Trailer.
Shit, dude. There's been an awakening.
Awakening?
Yeah, I just need to see this again.
Yeah,
I'm gonna see if I got any email about this.
Yeah, if anyone's got details, I saw chat acknowledge that Naoki Yoshida is the producer for the game. It is Business Division 3. I kind of assumed when that flashed up that it was gonna be the case. If you got any more details for us, you know, Blood, let us know. Chat, if you got some links to press reports. But
so far, all I have any email about is Hogwarts.
Sorry, I'm gonna pause this for a second, chat. I just wanted to see. Was right,
okay. And
they're all humans.
Basically, doesn't say anything.
The hype in chat is so wholesome; it just makes me happy.
Gosh, dude, a lot of good points for the disc version.
I know I bring it up way too much. Please bear with me, but I got heavy Naruto vibes in this Final Fantasy trailer when he turned into Ifrit, dude. It's like freaking Jinchurikis. They're probably like weapons of mass destruction.
Okay,
I'm not even kidding. That's the vibe I got.
So yeah, am I crazy?
Some power in him.
Does
like, are all the primals like people?
So they were talking about some kind of like plague or something. They were talking about some kind of like disease that was like, if it got in you, it like overtook you. And it sounded like maybe there's like some demonic nature to it. I don't know, Huber. It's pretty cool. So I want to clarify something. When I said in Final Fantasy 14, it's a Final Fantasy 14 thing. We're still image on Shiva right here. By the way, the Shiva looks like Luna Freya from Final Fantasy 15. I don't know if that's a coincidence or not. But in Final Fantasy 14, sorry, this is a spoiler, Final Fantasy 14 in Realm Reborn. Tune out for 5 seconds if you want to hear it. Lady Iceheart's a human, an Elizan, who can channel the power of primals and become Shiva at command, basically. Which is one of the first step of confirming that humans can be vessels for primals. They call them icons in this. So I want, and they use crystals to channel that power to summon using ether. And I wonder if it's some of the similar things there, which is a really cool concept. And man, that would be so awesome. Huber, I'm with you though. Like that vibes, very like cool. It was like the red glow and shit. It was like, dude, Ninetales is unleashed right now.
Yeah, dude. I'm so about that.
But look at this, the primals fighting each other. So like you saw that shot where Shiva's fighting Titan. If you rewatch it real quick, she tosses like icicles and then Titan punches them. I wonder if like each person has like maybe an icon or something attached to them. Like they're fighting in their place. I don't know.
Each nation has their own.
Yeah, like a nation thing. Titan. Holy shit.
So it is Naruto, like Huber said?
It's, yeah, he's got the Ninetales.
Oh, shit, dude. Oh, shit.
But I got to ask you about the style.
Shit. The tone of this game is awesome. Like blood, everything. Like I don't know if it's gonna be M-rated, but it's like a much more serious tone they're going for.
Totally,
and it's fantasy again.
Yeah, it's like medieval fantasy.
Fantasy,
yeah.
Man.
No,
I've been asking for this.
The coolest part.
I'm so 100% down on everything I saw for the entire thing. Yeah.
Oh crazy, shit! Crazy I didn't realize.
And
that.
I even liked it because I didn't dive too much into 15, but from what I played, I dug the combat. I kind of dug where they were going. I don't want them to like completely abandon, you know, the styles that they've done in the past. But I'm okay if like standard turn-based Final Fantasy kind of gets absorbed by just other parts of Final Fantasy. Like I go to Octopath for that now. I noticed that technically that, but like there I can get my fill of that. This just kind of more action oriented like stuff, especially because it was like borderline Souls looking. It was crazy. I'm curious to see. Yeah, and just that world. I mean, I don't like necessarily one thing over the other. I don't think one thing is equivocally like better than the other. I've just been so hungry to play something that looks like 11 or 14 that is not like some giant MMO that I got to commit to for a super long time.
How about that combat system, real-time combat?
Yeah. Looked very Devil May Cry.
This was the sickest part of the trailer.
I want to pause it so everyone. Yeah, the dude was using magic earlier too from his hand. So you know, like dodging, parrying. Like I think that looks awesome. But yeah, this dragoon part.
The dragoon dude.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
And you dodging it like that, such a badass like way to introduce. And then this phoenix. So there's two people you play as. I feel like at least. This younger
there were two dudes
dude,
they or, focused on at the end, yeah.
Or they, is it like just two different time periods? Later, yeah,
exactly.
I'm gonna tell.
Can you go back a little bit?
Sure. Where do you want to go?
That it might be just an older version of that looks really, really good.
Actually. Oh yeah, so I can like frame advance it for some of these dodges.
Yeah, I actually really like how the camera is positioned here.
Skip to the coral fight here because he does that.
It actually very much looks like the same way Devil May Cry is positioned when you're fighting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
In that shot specifically.
Sorry. Here we go. So
you think it's more like Devil May Cry or 15?
I think it'd be.
I won't know until I play it.
Yeah.
This looks more fluid than 15.
This all looks very Devil May Cry. Like
for sure.
Oh, I love. They're gonna do the visual.
Even the animations of the enemy attacks look very Devil May Cry.
Have you ever been able to play as a summon? Because that's happening.
Yeah, I mean, you issue controls, but you mean real time playing as a summon?
Yeah, real time.
Was that no? Because you summon in 15, you summon it just, but you don't control it. Chat, if you can recall any. Final Fantasy X. You play as the icons.
Oh,
so you summon
right.
Like Vale 4 and all of them. Duh.
That's right.
Final Fantasy 13, Final Fantasy 12, Zodiac Age. Yeah, Type 0. Duh.
Quite
you do it
few,
in Type
then.
0. Yeah. It's been around for a while.
But
this blood, like the beheading scene right here.
Yeah, this is
Witcher 3 right here.
Dude!
Yeah, they definitely seem to lean into that kind of thing a little bit more this, right? With the world feels more gritty.
Oh, Insomniac tweeted that Miles Morales is a launch title.
It's on PS4 also.
And PS4 also.
Yeah, oh my god, that's the devil buster right there. Like, that's
There you go, Huber. Naruto.
Dude, Keeley confirmed Demon's Souls is a launch title.
Whoa, really?
Window or launch Keeley. Date?
What?
He said title. A launch title.
Okay.
It's on PC too, by the way.
PS5, baby.
So
really?
Everybody wins, yeah.
What?
Wins. Now I face
everyone
the choice.
Everyone wins, baby.
Everybody wins.
So, I said this during the actual stream, but for the Final Fantasy III remake that they did, they have this really gorgeous concept art that accompanied it. And the character designs feel like they're pulled directly from that, but now they're covered in blood. And so it's a really interesting juxtaposition from kind of that very clean Final Fantasy classic aesthetic and a, like a more grittier, violent Type Zero kind of tone.
It seems like you're like playing through this guy's life or something, because I think that little boy, the teen, and the older guy are all the same dude, maybe?
Possibly, yeah. I'm definitely getting like the character designs, like even their outfits, the clothes they're wearing, get like Tactics / Ivelisse vibes. That's why I said that.
Oh, yeah.
Part.
Feels like Ivelisse.
The Legacy of the Crystal. That was like the title right there.
Kind of Ivelisse as well.
I have a bunch of news on Spider-Man.
Sorry, did we lose Huber?
Do you not
hear me?
Oh, we lost him.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Damiani looks like he lost all of us.
It was back.
Damiani? Are we there?
Yeah, you look like
are
you're
we
still
there?
There.
I think Zoom just hiccuped for a second. Yeah, we lost audio for a second there. Sorry, chat. I think Zoom might... Too many people are jumping on the Zoom to talk about Final Fantasy 16 right now. Sorry, Blood. You were mentioning something... sorry, Huber. You go first.
I was going
to
say, if it's Ivelisse, what are the odds of a Tactics companion piece?
Just put it on the Switch, you bastard.
A companion piece is a really interesting idea.
Because I feel like Final Fantasy likes to you know, they build a world and make a bunch of things with it. Or like trilogies and
I actually think I would spin-offs. Be more into that than like going the movie, you know, short anime series route and have it be companion games that kind of build up the world. Yeah, I agree. I think it's a really cool idea.
Yeah, is this the same character, just older age or something?
I think that the little kid, so like, this guy, and then the older guy are the same dude.
Yeah, so look at the earring. I mean, eye color.
Oh, four ages, maybe. Or yeah. No, that's the middle.
They're both together.
And he's got this brand on him right here.
Same eyes.
Yeah.
Same eyes. I mean, these two are for sure the same dude. Mm-hmm. But I think that little kid might be this guy, too.
If any of you recognize that tattoo on the face of the characters, let me know. It looks semi-familiar, but
it looks
maybe
like
it's original.
So many different Final Fantasy things. Yeah.
So that's a behemoth going against a phoenix there?
Phoenix, yeah.
Yeah. Jeez. Fantastic logo.
Yeah, it's cool, man.
Kind of FF10 colors a little bit.
Yeah, it is.
The logo seems more summon focused than usual. Usually you get like a couple characters in there where it's like that's just two summons going at it.
Lady or something.
So that's definitely going to be
Final Fantasy 16.
I had so many doubts.
What the hell?
I'm gonna watch.
What the hell?
I was 100% no. I was like,
good morning.
Good
morning,
Brandon. You saying
I thought too.
Summon focus. I'm thinking about Final Fantasy 15 and the way that they did summons as kind of like this big event, and you could like see the effects in the world, but there weren't that many summons, and it felt like very limited. Yeah. It'd be cool if summons could like more consistently do kind of like environmental destruction or were a bigger part of combat. Like the 15 planet and expand upon it.
I like them being just a bigger part of the story. I think that was one finally like really diving into the Final Fantasy VII story, like playing at least just the first part in Remake and replaying that part like in the old version of the game. I forgot. It was like, oh, it's kind of disappointing in VII that like if the summons are just like, oh yeah, we got summons. And it's like, where did they come from? How do you get good at using them? What, like, they didn't, nobody really talked about them in a way that like placed them into the world, like, and so it'd be neat to see how this world like reveres them or is scared of them, or if like a new one is introduced and all of them react to it, you see how the world reacts to, you know, like Pacific Rim, Huber, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, dude.
But I just like they're fun things to contextualize because there's no right answer. I like it when each like Final Fantasy does its own thing. So I'm excited they're getting a little more of a focus because I think they're the way they're factored into 14's plot is really interesting.
I love that combo into the fire blast there. Like, just thinking about the potential of launching them up in the air and like getting enemies into certain states where they're more vulnerable.
Give me those details, Doug.
All right, so here we go. Final Fantasy 14 producer Naoki Yoshida here. How did you enjoy the trailer? The exclusive footage comprised of both battles and cutscenes running in real time represents but a fraction of what our team has accomplished since the start of development on this, an all-new Final Fantasy game. In that span, the team size has grown from a handful of core members to a full-fledged unit that continues to polish and build upon what they have created so far to provide all players with experience unmatched in terms of story and gameplay. Our next big information reveal is scheduled for 2021. So in the meantime, I expect everyone to have fun speculating as we have a lot in store, not only for Final Fantasy 16, but Final Fantasy 14 too. Needless to say, I'm working hard on both. And then the director.
14 too?
Yeah, 14 as well.
14 as well.
I've been paying attention to the combat and in different scenes of the combat, he has different colored arms, and it seems like one is like a phoenix arm, one is like a titan arm. And so I bet you like equip the summons and it changes almost like a class, the type of skills that you have available. And like maybe like if you equip titan, you're slower, but you do more damage. Yeah. It kind of seems like if you watch the combat, there's some sort of fusion with the summons that changes how you play. Which is
pre-orders
sick.
Are tomorrow, by the way.
Keely for PlayStations?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, Keely's got a lot of these scoops because I've been seeing them on the official channels.
And would that mean that the character is like all of the summons then? Or like he
probably has like at least two of them. Or maybe people can inhabit them or take them.
Right, like, yeah. I wonder if it'll be like a lightning return situation where like you can kind of be everything and you're focused on one character, or if it's going to be multiple characters and it's like only these characters can equip these summons. I have no idea.
Yeah, it could be like how you change like the this might there be their equivalent of their job system.
Yeah,
job crystals. The director of the game is Hiroshi Takai. They were on 14 in Stormblood. They were the director of The Last Remnant, and they've been attached to the Saga series for forever. So they come from that background. So that is who will be directing the game.
Oh man, like you think about the Saga influence, like that to me says like there's going to be a focus on multiple characters, maybe over different periods of time as well. That would be interesting.
Just getting started.
Damn, dude, that looks so super good,
man. All right,
wow,
that was
Final Fantasy 16.
I could be completely wrong here, what? But does Shiva share any similar markings to anything else that we see on the human characters? Because it looked like she had some markings, and I don't know if we saw that show up on anyone else. I don't know.
Sorry, it's like right after the shot, isn't it?
Dude, I'm anticipating the peaceful town segment of the game. They keep showing the kid just like walking around.
Right.
Yeah.
Excited for that.
Got that same like cross.
Yeah.
Like the clothing and let me frame it.
I like everyone's like Victorian vibes in this.
It's just really ornate clothing.
Kind of looks like that human character though.
Yeah.
The blonde lady.
Yeah, she like has a very similar face as the blonde lady.
Jinchuriki's dude.
Pretty cool design, and like it's this guy right here is this is trying to see. No, I just sorry. I was like, you're smashed. You're done.
There's like a crystal tower in the background almost dominating right there.
I think that was
sure just ice.
I think it was just debris like from
crystal tower.
You mean in this part right here?
When it's
up?
Falling down.
Yeah, like
I'm sure it's just ice.
I thought,
just like
I thought it was debris from the fight.
Looks like a building.
Yeah, definitely maybe a crystal tower. Sorry, it's on a
bike. Okay, there we go. Nova Crystallis.
That dog.
that dog. That was when I was in, dude.
Look at that.
So it looks like the young version of the dude is hanging out with this kid. So I guess they're not the same person.
That is. That's Max Pander. Let's see. Like, you thought maybe like this girl. Like,
no. Keep going.
The blonde lady. You'll see.
Yes. Yeah. That lady.
Okay. Let me back up.
Her chin is a little less sharp than Shiva's.
Yeah, and you know there may be nothing to that at all. I have no idea, but just something that crossed my mind.
Dude, it makes sense. She could be like coming to this town to teach him. How to control it?
They're like, yeah, like look at this.
Like look, that's.
Mhm. Maybe they're part of the Fire Nation.
Hey, bro, can I borrow Ifrit for a bit? Touch my hand.
I like the design of that. Yeah, the buildings, the village, and stuff there. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
So. Dude. Yeah, like is he going to train or something, or he's got this like thing on his.
But they're gonna treat him like a prisoner.
Yeah, every time I see that kid, I think Red Mage. I agree.
All right, bye.
Sarah.
Oof. What else did we have? Oh, yeah.
So much.
Miles Morales is next, and I've got the
Miles Morales.
All right, I'll get Miles going.
Demon's Souls, Resident Evil.
Yeah, there's a lot of interesting things that they posted in terms of details. It is coming to PS4 as well. It is coming at launch. They did talk about having an upgrade path. So if you buy the PS4 version and then you get the PS5. It's kind of
for free?
Let me read this out because it's kind of confusing. Supports a next-gen upgrade path. So even if you aren't ready to upgrade to PS5 just yet, there's nothing stopping you from buying the PS4 version and enjoying the game alongside everyone else at launch. While it doesn't have the enhancement made possible by the console and the PS5 version, the game still looks beautiful on PS4 and PS4 Pro, and you can rest easy that when you do make the jump to PS5, the game comes with you. Okay, so yeah.
Okay.
The game is only $50.
Ah.
Okay. But
that means it's
they have,
short.
a $70 Ultimate Edition that also includes Spider-Man Remastered.
Oh, huh. Remastered?
Yeah. And it has all the DLC, and it has, it's a lot more than just, they say it's not just a simple up-res. They've got a lot of other ray tracing and ambient shadows and lighting.
Ray
and
tracing.
A whole bunch of new
oh, that's so hype. Man, holy shit.
They're leaving the Spider-Man off their 100 PS Plus games, probably.
I wish I could bring my save file over so I could just do New Game Plus, though. Like,
maybe you
can.
Probably can.
You can.
Yeah.
I wonder.
PlayStation Plus, baby.
Guess I'll play Spider-Man
and it's
again.
Targeted 60 frames per second frame rate.
Only 60?
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Huh.
They gotta ease their way into
it. I don't think you're gonna see too many console games above 60.
Ease into that.
5 is touting 120 all over their website.
So, yeah, as some have pointed out, though, no mention about if you already own a copy playing it on PS5 just without the enhancements. Is that even a possibility? Because they didn't really, I mean, also to get into, they didn't talk about anything about backwards compatibility.
They didn't talk about, I imagine there will be some kind of backwards compatibility with a limited boost mode type of thing, but yeah.
DMC5 Special Editions, 120 frames, chat? Are you serious?
Holy
120
shit.
Frames, Virgil.
Dude, fucking, oh, yeah. Fucking pull it right
That's
now.
The only way you can see
trigger.
Everything.
Pull my Devil Trigger. Let's go.
No, it'd be amazing if, like, it's a 60 frames and he activates Devil Trigger and it goes 120 frames. Yeah, let's see that frame rate. Shh. I mean, this combat looked pretty good, though, in Miles Morales.
Yeah, I agree.
Holy
crap. I love how the two new enemy types are, like, so bright. It was clearly, like, purple guy, red guys.
Yeah.
That helps, actually.
And they're both bad.
The only thing that I was, like, that crossed my mind when I was watching is I do think the combat looks super, super good, and it was very fun in original Spider-Man. But just the colors, especially with, like, all the yellow stuff that Miles is doing and the purple stuff of the enemies, I'm like, oh, I hope, you know, it remains readable in combat, but it'll probably be fine.
Ease into it, I imagine.
Ease into it, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, OG Spider-Man isn't in that PS Plus thing? Huh. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's probably left out of that top 100.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a bummer. But all those top 100s are all specifically the enhanced versions that they did.
Yeah, the Bloodborne, just... dude, seriously, day one.
Yeah. It just seems
well,
so much
Demon
more
Souls,
flashy.
Demon Souls day one.
Yeah.
Jeez. God almighty. Oh,
I still haven't seen anyone other than Jeff saying the Demon Souls day one, but I mean, Jeff's never wrong, so.
Jeff's king of exclusives, man.
And he's scoops.
He's got scoops.
Jeff, don't guess. Jeff, no.
I don't know. Jeff told me that he knew what was in the center of the galaxy in No Man's Sky before that game came out, so.
Damn.
Huh? I mean, so, he might have.
Jeff, maybe he didn't warn you.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, I know.
Yeah.
This just looks so fun. Oh, yeah, a little camouflage meter. I didn't see that the first time.
Just separate from up your webs.
MGS3,
like
dude. MGS3.
Yeah.
I think this is, easily going to be a crowd pleaser. It's going to be interesting. I mean, just beyond like performance and character, just having. I did not finish Spider-Man thinking Insomniac had many lessons to learn from that game. It was like, a nice attempt, but two better be good. So it's just like them being like, all right, now, because I'm sure all that DLC had pretty much been, you know, finished and they were just kind of cleaning up after the game came out. So them like going back and starting a whole new project, like,
plus Miles Morales. I just love that character.
He's great. Yeah. I'm excited to see what all his suits are going to be.
Ooh,
a lot of Peter
suits.
I was like, oh, these suits. But like, I don't know Miles. Uh-oh. I don't know his outfits and his variants. And
we got a Keely update. Keely says, I am hearing some retailers may make inventory available today as well. Stay tuned. That's for pre-orders for PS5.
Oh, doing to
here
a
we
Sony.
Go.
Somebody give them a
firing
call.
Up all the websites.
Dude, it's chaos right now.
Yo, with the 3080 launch as well.
Guys, I'm just going to get the
launch.
Information.
The internet's dead tonight.
Milo,
goodbye.
You can check, okay?
I have to buy a 4K TV, too. I'm going to spend like $3,000 in the next couple of days. Rip me.
Man, just to like counter Microsoft to be like, and X, we're moving up the Xbox Series X pre-orders to today as well.
Yeah, they're like, Xbox,
go all out.
Take one.
24 hours of pre-orders.
You know, one thing that makes me curious when we're talking about the two prices, and the rumors that there was the 450, I kind of wonder if, in a way, Microsoft going ahead and announcing 500 is almost like PlayStation having the safety net of, you know what? We can do 500. You know?
Sure.
It's like, they did it, we'll do the same price and we'll make a little more money.
Yeah, no, I really do wonder where both of these events going to happen.
Changeable those things are.
I wonder.
Well, the fact that the digital is $100 less, people were speculating 50 tops.
Yeah,
100 right. is pretty wild.
Pretty good deal if you don't care about backwards. If they're just like trying to jump in, I think the backwards compatibility.
I watched so many movies.
I've gone all digital for a long time, and my PS4 disc drive being broken for years and beeping constantly makes me kind of want to just, like, I don't trust their hardware.
That's a good point.
Like, yeah, 4K, I feel like the Pro 4K in Criterion movies had more issues in the early runs. Because multiple people have issues with their Pros.
Yeah, what are all the launch games that are confirmed at this time? Do we know?
Demon's Souls, Spider-Man, DMC. Is that Sackboy game?
All you need.
Wasn't Ratchet Clank?
Oh, yeah, Sackboy.
Ratchet Clank is Window.
Yeah. And then the Astro Boy Experience, whatever that game is.
Yeah, that,
five count.
Oh, yeah, that'll be launch, yeah. Destruction All-Stars, maybe.
I love how offensive Spider-Man is in those games. Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. your defense is just more offense. It's like, keep moving, keep juggling, for keep sure. hitting.
Well, you do your defense so as sick. You're doing your offense. Like, you don't stop to do your defense. You just, like,
keep it going.
Dodging on your way to punch somebody. It's really great. Yeah, it is very offensive. You're right.
What was the webbing? Was Next Blood?
Yeah. Webbing him to a wall is great.
Yeah.
The next is Hogwarts Legacy.
There was no year on that, right? So that's probably
I have the email. Let me see if they said anything more about it. 2021.
Oh, we've been hearing that game forever.
Yeah.
Well, the first one was a leak. Was this the original, the actual original first official announcement?
Yeah, I think so. All
right.
Yeah, they say it's their own experience with RPG gameplay, unlike anything else in the Wizarding World, which will continue to build fan appeal. Like, it doesn't really say much other than it's an RPG with magic and a detailed, mysterious story.
Look like character creator probably too.
Yeah, it looks like it. What was next after that?
I have two things. First of all, Final Fantasy 16 is only a timed console exclusive for PlayStation 5.
Makes sense.
And PlayStation's official Twitter account has tweeted out that retailers will start taking pre-orders tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
The PlayStation Twitter account.
Today.
Retailers.
Pre-orders tomorrow?
Yeah,
that's what PlayStation said.
They said
what time day
is that? Is that midnight?
We don't know. We don't
know.
We don't know, Huber.
Not counting the van. You get to spend all day waiting.
Whenever any of you here, I want an immediate phone call. I'll extend you the same courtesy.
Thank you.
Call of Duty was the next thing after Hogwarts,
standard,
whatever it's called.
Right. Standard Call of Duty.
Yeah.
Driving up the car, like swerving out and driving up the airplane wing. I was
it's weird because I enjoyed the Call of Duty sequence, but I don't have that much to say about it.
I mean,
Hogwarts Legacy is coming to like a million platforms. Yeah, by the way.
All right, I'm sure that'll be on everything.
Yeah. That's fair, Ben, because I don't want to undersell how crazy the Black Ops sequence is with this whole, you know.
Right.
Plane heist, but it is, like Ian was saying, more of it, like thematically we get something like this just about every year. I know they took a year off, but thematically and the spectacle is what we expect.
Yeah, I think that's the perfect way to frame it. Like, so much of this looks really good, and I think the feedback on the weapons looks phenomenal. And it is like a well done choreographed sequence, but thematically it is very similar to stuff we've seen before. Yeah, absolutely.
Love these characters, though.
What
love
was
Black
next?
Ops characters.
After next Todd. Is Resident Evil Village.
Hell yeah.
Nice.
I love this fairy tale.
I mean, the two biggest things are that fairy tale and then the merchant at the end.
I just want to see him shoot something They didn't show anything like that, did they?
Yeah.
Brad, it's all just so
touching doors and walking around through forests.
Pop someone real quick. Pop. Dude, Chris friggin' popped him in the last show.
What if you don't shoot because you're a werewolf and you just claw everybody, but they don't want to show that yet?
Interesting. But kind of weird.
Yeah, it'd be a departure for the series.
Like, there's almost no way we're not turning into a werewolf, right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, something like that. There's the shot where you're walking in the snow, and that is a very, I'm turning into a werewolf walk.
Right.
Dude, yeah. Huber, the final fight will be werewolf v. werewolf. That's dude, the final fight of the game.
The final fight will be
Chris will be a werewolf too, dude.
Oh my god, dude.
Werewolf.
Didn't they at some point talk about like this wrapping up the story from Seven?
Maybe.
Wasn't this supposed to be like the last game with Ethan or something?
Right. So that's makes me wonder if
the whole game builds to what you think is the final confrontation is Ethan werewolf versus Chris werewolf, and they're fighting. But then Wesker werewolf drops in halfway through. Uneasy Alliance, both werewolf, Chris and Ethan fight Wesker werewolf. And then at the end, they do the Schwarzenegger hand thing.
Wesker is a vampire, and it's vampire v.
Yo.
Chris and Ethan werewolf.
Oh my
Wesker
god.
Wesker and his kids.
Yeah.
Alexandra and whatever. They're all vampires.
Alex Wesker.
Alex Wesker.
Reveal yourself.
Vampire, dude.
I got one more confirmation.
Beyond werewolf,
I hope the merchant has a line about like a family business.
Yes,
the older version of the four one.
Or it's like his son or grandson or something.
It'd be so sick if like somehow they could read a save file of yours from like the HD version. If you ever shot the merchant, he gets like angry at you at first or something, reads your save data. It's like, I'm not selling to you.
You guys are out of control right now.
Dude, this is Capcom, man. They're out of control right now with all these games. I wanted to, on the official Final Fantasy 16 page for Square Enix, confirms it is a standalone single-player action RPG. So single-player, no multiplayer.
Wow. Yeah, beautiful.
This guy, the penguin.
Yo, GameStop Ireland has pre-orders.
What does he say?
Yeah. What is want to hear it again? Yeah, I can sound it up.
They don't get it till later, though, Huber.
Got it.
Remember, they don't get it November 12th.
Oh, yeah. All
right, here you go.
Staggered release.
Yep.
Here's what he says.
Where you pre-order?
Oh, yeah. Okay, where are you? Okay.
If it's just looking, window shop away.
It's pandering for sure, but I can get behind it.
Yeah, I'm here for it.
What are you pre-ordering?
What are you pre-ordering?
What are you pre-ordering?
It's funny because I actually haven't pre-ordered anything other than to preload in a long time.
Yeah.
I really liked that trailer too, just teasing the castle. Really hyping it up. Mm. Like just outside the gates right there.
Yeah.
The village.
Awesome.
What else we got? I see the list, so we have technically five more things they showed off, but what was
we've got Deathloop was next up.
It's cool.
Deathloop.
Looks good.
Which
excited.
It's just funny, it's not on this page.
The largely idea of Dishonored, but you kind of have to put the pieces in place to get your assassinations there, and you can do multiple, like just more customized assassination sounds really cool and like a very good expansion of things they've already done well.
I'm already super invested in the main character. Just every time they show him, every time we hear his narration of like, I gotta get the hell out of here. Like, I'm just super. Well,
they're talky way more than they do in Dishonored games. Like Corvo didn't even like talk in the first game.
Yeah.
So Wario64 has posted that on the Japanese blog, they're saying that Sackboy and Horizon will also be coming to PS4.
Really? Horizon?
Horizon Whoa. Coming to PS4.
Yeah.
Whoa. That's compromised.
Yeah, we have the
True.
With upgrade paths.
Yeah, they just say here,
this gun like, reminds me of No Country for Old Men. Like, it has the sound. Oh,
the we got the price of the DualSense controller.
Oh,
what do you think it was, Huber?
I thought it was 100, but I see that it's $70.
Yep, $69.99.
That is a win. That is a win.
I mean, it's a win from 100, but
yeah,
that's a lot of money.
And we have the launch day. We have the launch day games from the official PlayStation blog.
Let's hear that.
Just
let's hear
it. I know you already said them from the Japanese blog, but from the English blog, it says Astro's Playroom, which will be pre-installed. Demon Souls, Destruction All-Stars, Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales, an Ultimate Edition, and Sackboy, A Big Adventure.
Wow, that's it, huh? Oh,
wow.
Surprised.
Dude, Demon Souls and Spider-Man are
Demon
like...
Demon Souls will be... there's $69.99.
Yeah.
Oh! Wait, so, what?
Yeah.
As,
we got,
did it?
Demon Souls will be $69.99.
It happened? Oh, shit.
It's happening. Spike.
Yo, next gen has arrived. Shit.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know why they're not including special edition in that launch lineup too, because that they said it would be launched.
That was like the first game they said that was launched.
But that's not from Sony.
Oh, sure. Okay. Gotcha.
These are from
that makes
Sony
sense.
Worldwide
that
Studios,
makes sense.
Yeah.
$70.
$70, dude.
After tax, almost 80.
Yeah, those are the chat. That was the first party.
Yeah, 1,000 a day, 10,000 a day,
2,000 a day, 10,000 a day. People will pay.
And yeah, the digital downloads are still going to be
$70.
It's a launch title.
Okay.
Yeah, it's November exclusive.
They said it's launching.
Call of Duty is the 13th, so yeah, it'll basically be launch.
Okay. And I'm sure we'll hear about Demons and Miles Morales.
And third party Ubisoft, I imagine Watch Dogs and.
Assassin's Creed
being available.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
because Watch
stacked.
Dogs date is the
isn't
29th
Watch Dogs
October? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that I'm just probably gonna wait to play Watch Dogs then.
Same.
And
yeah,
Assassin's
same.
Creed is the 10th. That's on the Xbox launch. And, so.
Ryota Suzuki, designer Devil May Cry 5 and Dragon's Dogma, has joined the Square Enix team as the battle director of.
Yep.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, they announced that a while ago.
Yeah, that's that. Monk Wrestler was just reminding us about that. So if you're curious about that battle system.
Very promising,
yeah.
For sure.
10 out of 10 hyped for Deathloop. I'm still so intrigued by the female character and how she's implemented. Like,
right.
Yeah,
do you quick join a game and you get matched into somebody's loop and you just try to stop him? Does
they,
she have
they
her
have
own...
Not... said that
campaign.
Right, they haven't said
yeah
that.
We
haven't
know.
Really
don't
specified
know.
How it works mechanically so here's an interesting thing on those games that are coming out on PS4 if you have the PS4 disc and the disc version you can also upgrade to PS5
Ooh.
But
what
but
if you have a digital version
if you have the digital version you can if you have right, the digital version you can upgrade as well but okay. Obviously if you have the disc and you buy the digital PS5 then there's no upgrade path for you.
Whoa.
That makes sense.
So,
you buy a PS4 disc, but you don't have a disc drive, then you can't upgrade it.
Is the upgrade
Whoa.
Free in every instance? Okay.
So, by getting one or two free upgrades with a disc, you've paid for your disc-based version, in a way?
In a way,
some
yeah.
weird logic there.
Yeah, it's really
the Japanese blog has some extra it. Specs on the PS5, such as USB-C and 10 gigabit USB-A. Pale Monkey is speculating this is how the VR support will work, potentially.
Yeah, because they showed the new camera.
Yeah, the camera's in here, too. Dual 1080p lenses.
Nah.
$60.
Because
and for sure, there's no difference other than the disk drive in the two versions.
A Slack message is not enough. I expect a phone call.
I'm driving to your house.
Okay.
And I will deliver you a handwritten letter.
Yeah.
That is
with
my
a bunch of like papers. Yeah.
With my family seal. Okay. Black seal. And it will be written in blood.
Virgil.
The retailers.
Yeah.
It will be.
I'll send my hawk with a scroll, Huber. Nothing's faster than that. He's not bound by
There you
Something's
go.
Faster.
Yeah, Ian, faster. It very perfect, clearly says here, done. Both PS5 models use the same custom processor with integrated CPU and GPU. All the same stuff, basically.
So it's not really a Series S situation. That's good.
It really
the
is.
The hard drives
are
the same?
Yeah.
Size?
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking, too, with Deathloop, if you're the female character and your only mission is to kill the guy, but then
the guy's got way more to do.
The guy has all these objectives. Like, does that mean you go in as the girl and you're just spending the first few minutes like waiting to see what he does, and then you just go try to cut him off? Are you just constantly like running after him? Like, I'm really curious.
It's a different game mode where like she comes in 70% of the way through his session, you know, and so you can just be in a quick playlist as the woman and just try over and over again.
Yeah.
If you play as her too. But I'm sure she has to do stuff too. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But, or so if you want to play specifically with a buddy, is there a way they can be like guaranteed to keep coming back into your game? And as much as I love the stylization of this trailer, it is interesting to sell a game with like, I've done this so many times. It's like,
yeah.
As a sell, you know, it's like, I've killed this guy 40 times. I'm getting tired of it. And it's like, and I'm going to pay money for this. Okay. You know, it's a weird, I'm like excited. It's just it's strange to hear somebody talk about how like repetitive it is. Like,
so I've been playing a lot of Spelunky 2 right now where that's
getting
pretty much
better.
All you do.
Yeah.
I'm okay with it. I don't think that's necessarily a bad thing.
So pumped. Yeah.
And he dies so many times in the trailers, it just seems like that would be something they would want
to
keep it a fast.
I got the email too, but it looks like it's just the same thing as the blog.
Wait, so 80 euros for what? 80 euros for games now? Instead of 60?
That's what 70 is in euros. Right? Or no, wait, it would be the other way.
80 euros from 60?
Yeah, it depends on what they were paying for prices before. You can't just like do the math on the conversion.
Yeah.
80 in Europe because we don't have to pay extra tax?
Oh, that's true. Yeah, the tax is included in prices in Europe.
Yeah, that would be closer to 90.
Jeez.
Here, right?
Yeah, it's like $95.
Jeez.
Whew. Canada, they're like $100 too. Man.
We've circled back to Neo Geo prices, everybody.
Come full circle.
Good pull,
Neo
Don.
Geo
pull.
Prices. It's like, I wonder now, because we avoided it for so long, the games are...
Wait, Damiani, did we skip
long enough?
DMC?
So it's like the value is going to matter even more.
Did
now
we?
We're going to get back to that era of like, well, how long's the game? Oh, it's $100. It needs to be long for me to buy it.
Oh, sorry, when I have an order then. Yeah, sorry. Spoiled Demon Souls.
But you're already showing Demon Souls.
Sorry, spoiled Demon Souls for everyone. You're not supposed to know it exists. I'm sorry. We are out of order. So a few things people want you to know: that Horizon, the second one, whatever it's called, I forget, is crossplay. It'll be coming to PS4.
Don't
Cry Cry's Virgil DLC will be available as paid DLC as well separately.
Chat is saying there's a new difficulty.
Yes, cool. So they tweeted out there's a
hopefully
legendary...
they're all available at launch.
Yeah, and it supports ray tracing. They put in the tweet that was a big one.
Nice, like Fortnite, ray tracing.
They included all the specs on the.
He's perfect. He's a perfect boy.
On the PS5, the SSD is 825 gigabytes. It's not a full terabyte.
Weird. Where are you seeing that?
I love replaying the games. Email. I'll replay this 100%. No matter what, I'll replay DMC5. For sure.
V is definitely my least favorite character to play in DMC5, even though I still enjoyed him. But the idea of summoning him out of Virgil... and like mixing up the combat that way just seems so brilliant to me.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Does he control the same? Look like he was doing his own.
No,
action
he plays
there.
Way different.
Way.
No,
different.
But I mean, he like the other dudes do the action where it looked like he had a weapon and was going. He was doing his.
Not
own
sure
stuff.
What you're saying.
The character you're talking about that he summons does not attack himself. He has like demons from what I remember.
Yeah,
from the
he
game.
Has summons.
And in the gameplay I saw here, he was doing the action himself. Like he had a sword and was. Directly attacking.
Yeah, that's a good question. Let me
here it is.
Into it right now.
He has the like kills.
He's
like,
still using
he
the
he does
like
yeah,
stab
yeah.
cane.
Yeah. I didn't see anything there. So he has cane finishers.
That's the same.
As it is in DMC5. Yeah.
I posted all the specs in Slack.
Nice. Ooh, thanks, Blood. Take a look at. Those are spec sheets, all right.
Is the most fun to play. Just switching between weapons.
Let's see.
Just the fact that they're not broken into two is good. So.
Yeah.
You see so little of Lady Intrition 5 that I'm like trying to convince myself that they're teasing playable Lady Intrish, which, you know, they did. They've done before. Yeah.
It's like a Kyrie situation, dude. Forgot they were in it.
So, chat, you were right. Has PS5 will have a USB Type A port, high speed, USB Type A port, super speed, USB 10 gigabytes per second, and a USB Type C port with 10 gigabytes per second. 2x of the 10 gigabyte per second Type A ports. So, one Type A high speed, two Type A 10 gigabytes, and one Type C 10 gigabytes. So, there you go. So, I know some people are very curious about that.
I wonder if they'll give more story for Virgil than they do in like DMC4 Special Edition. Like you definitely get different story, but it's not very much. And so I wonder if that's going to be expanded, especially since Virgil plays such a huge part of the story. And like there's many moments where you could do it from his perspective and get a lot more insight into how he's feeling at that time.
Like if he had his own full dedicated branch.
Yeah.
Ben, do you think they could do that?
Yeah, I mean it looks like you're going through the same areas, but I just wonder in terms of cutscenes if they're going to be more like how expanded those are going to be or what how they're going to present it, I guess.
Keely update. Keely reconfirmed it'll be tomorrow for pre-orders officially. Gotcha, I do not have a time for you.
Okay.
Got it. Also the
can somebody have Keely call me?
Sure. I'll set up an in-stock alert with Keely personally. He'll personally call
Keely,
you
give
when
me
it's
a call.
In stock. Just a voicemail. For the Wi-Fi networking, it's IEEE 802.11, A, B, G, N, A, C, and A, and A, X. For those of you who are curious, also has Bluetooth 5.1. Man, this
Demon Souls.
Demon Souls. Okay, here you go. Demon Souls. Let's, like, we can confirm Demon Souls exists. That.
Demon Souls.
Have at it.
Goaty just got interesting.
Or not interesting because it's just going to win.
Yeah, I'm curious, Brad, like now that you just played through it, you know, how do you feel? Because I know some people like had, you know,
reservations
about
the
art style and that kind of thing. Yeah.
I mean, to me, it's a remake and I'm cool with them doing something different. I don't necessarily need it to be the same game. I think it still looks really good. It looks a little different. It doesn't have exact the same tone, but I like the tone it has.
I think it looks gorgeous.
Yeah,
it
looks great to me.
People don't like the way it looks. What?
Yeah, some people don't like the way it looks.
Oh my God, it looks freaking
perfect. There's only one
perfect.
Thing I can comment on. As someone who has not really played a lot of this and not an expert on this.
I think there's a feeling there's some embellishment, yeah.
I understand that easy stuff, whatever, like one hit kills, whatever, those for the purpose of smoothing things out. I want to know if that god mode enabled affected the physics of being hit when you were blocking. So it looked like he didn't move at all.
It honestly looked like he had unlimited stamina. Go back to the shot where it pulls up.
Sure.
And frame by frame.
I know what you're talking about. So you want this run here frame by frame.
Yeah.
I think the
we just barely see the broken one.
Sorry, Ian.
Well, I'm just trying to see if the broken one is.
There's no way they're going to reveal that.
This
cuts out at the perfect time.
But it's such like an interesting cut that it almost leads me to believe that.
It's fascinating.
Here we go. Because it would be this one. It would be the second one up in the right corner. Right?
I don't think we see it.
Be like behind the statue almost. So you probably can't see it.
I thought it was the second from one up on the right.
It's at the top. There's like two at the top in the middle.
Yeah, you can't tell.
Yeah, I don't know if you'll be able to see it.
Even if it was it.
I don't know if anybody else agrees with this, but I think I think the animation, like when he's walking and running and leaping over the thing, looked really good. Mm-hmm. There were some times where they were like, he was doing the combat that the animations looked odd to me. Like they didn't seem quite as smooth as when he was just by himself.
Well, let's see. Let's take a look.
At 16 seconds, amazing. You can see it broken, apparently.
Oh, okay. Damn.
Like that looks really good.
Mm-hmm. Cool backstab, dude.
Yeah.
Chat, we're talking about a broken arch stone. There are statues that teleport you to different, basically, levels, because this is a hub game. And the implication is if one of them is not broken,
like
added content would be there.
Got it.
Can you go back and maybe like slow down when he stabs the shield?
Yeah.
Because that, I think that's kind of what I'm trying to get at.
There we go.
Ragdoll. Is it Ragdoll? It looks Ragdoll, right?
It'd be very...
There's havoc on everything.
Spirit. Yeah.
I mean, I think that this character's
in this slow-mo.
Yeah,
this character's god mode, for sure.
He clips, through, yeah.
Yeah,
I think his poise is just, like, maximum.
Yeah, well, and he slides back a little bit before he...
Yeah, the attack animation went around him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We already mentioned the PC.
We already mentioned PC. It's awesome.
It's coming to PC.
We know.
Everybody wins.
We mentioned all the things you wanted. $70, PC.
Everybody wins. PC. PC.
That's the question, though. Is like, I'm buying a 3080 tomorrow, too. Do I get this on PC or PS5?
So, my question is, with, like, the god mode enabled, is it affecting the principles of combat?
I mean, I think his character would just have really high poise, so he wouldn't get knocked back.
This lighting is, like, the Dark Souls 2 promise of lighting. Like, we're actually finally getting it. Like, this darkness looks so good, and what I want Soul's Darkness to look like, it's so exciting.
I don't remember if you could parry shield attacks. I don't remember that. Chat, maybe you'll know.
I like the sword block, too. The two-handed sword block.
Really like the way the cloth is animating on his back.
I really wonder how much they change.
Are you going to leave that item there?
Combat.
It's going to feel a little different. So if you want it to feel exactly like PS3, it will not, probably.
I don't want it to.
It'll feel close.
I want it to feel more like Dark Souls 3.
It's kind of janky, but it works, obviously, still. But...
How do you like?
I actually really liked the way that he died there. That was a nice spin.
Yeah, the way he just like shoved that sword up into him.
Is there any like loading things being?
There's no
non-existent like now that were present before.
The war, like when he touched the bonfire thing earlier. I don't remember how fast that load was. There's usually like a little load, I think.
But
though.
It didn't show the monumental or whatever. Like,
I mean, they haven't showed it. Wait, monumental's not there at that part.
No, I mean in the load screens, it would sometimes show like.
It shows, So it might not have like loads like that.
Rare rabbit. We already covered
blood
that.
Blood on this.
Yeah,
there's like elongated nipples sticking off his body.
So sick.
Like the lighting in this room is way different than the original game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like way
different. So I love the way the tutorial guy looks. I don't like the huge died text when we're at the end. And the way it pops up.
Yeah, the text is like.
Yeah.
Not as clean as I'd like. But
that bridge, dude.
Oh my god, this is perfect. That shot is
this
perfect.
Fog right here is great. Oh yeah. Latria.
Remember, we're at a delay to chat because we're watching the stream. So that's you have to specify what you're looking at.
Stonefang, yeah. I mean, the gargoyle is like sick too. Oh, is that spider move new? I don't remember. With the oil?
The lighting up the oil?
So. I don't remember. I can't remember. Maybe chat will know too.
I don't remember.
10 out of 10.
We're not nitpicking it, chat. Relax.
16 right now.
Oh yeah.
Pointing out what's different.
If that's an arch stone there, then the other one is broken. Because it's not lit up.
Dude, consuming this on a brand new console, that is the dream. My gosh.
Yeah.
And PC though too.
So
everybody wins pretty much.
Everybody wins. $70.
Now everyone can play.
Gabe Newell gets a cut.
Getting that cut,
I can't wait to buy the PS5 version and the PC version because it's fucking Demon Souls. Like, what else am I gonna do?
Yeah, I can't wait to play the PC version and get killed by hackers immediately. It's gonna be tight.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, dude.
But I'll buy both versions too.
Sorry.
DMC5 Special Edition.
Feel good.
And Demon's Souls at launch.
And Resident Evil and freaking Final Fantasy. No, I'm just saying all the games we saw already.
Yeah, yeah. No, I just like, I don't even feel like I need to eat anymore. Like, I'm. I am sustained.
Yeah.
Oh, we had a mid-roll ad chat. Okay.
Mid-rolls are going to be entirely user specific. So
yeah, some people get them, some people don't.
Yeah, they're running an experiment on those.
Yeah, probably we had one.
But we have no control over that, so don't get mad at me.
God damn, that sure looks good.
And also, you know, if you're a sub, you won't see those either. So there's additional incentive to subscribe.
Which one is Storm King?
Four?
That they showed it, yeah.
Yeah,
that lightning strike too.
Yeah, lightning strike. It looks so good.
I don't know if that lightning strike's in the original either. I can't remember.
I don't remember it.
It would be really neat if you could have effects like that that kind of change the level. That
sure, dude. If Tendency did stuff like that,
dude. I was just gonna say Tendency, dude. I'm so stoked for everyone to be confused about World Tendency again.
I wonder if they'll make it way more clear.
Yeah.
I think that'd be a smart move.
I'm curious about that for sure.
This game punishes you for, like, the game gets harder when you're struggling at it.
When you die in human form, it's bad.
I kind of want to see what Phalanx looks like.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
I'm curious what the input of Blue Point versus From is. Like, if there's just things, you know, that From is says, hey, you know, we were rushed on this project. It was like the first one of these. We didn't, you know, like if we had to do it again, we would change things. And this is a list of things we would change.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Crazy. That guy just like tanking the fire.
That is my favorite shot of the whole trailer.
What, the dragon one?
No,
the Latria one?
Yeah, Tower of Latria. It's like...
Yeah, that's crazy.
Tower of Latria is one of the best areas in any Souls game. And it looks like they're nailing it.
The lighting looks bonkers.
Yeah, I like the lightning hitting that tree. It's cool.
Yeah, very cool.
What's funny about the you died text being bland is the you died text has always been bland. We're just used to a specific flavor of bland.
Yeah, maybe.
Right.
I'm trying to remember what it looked like in the OG Demon's Souls. Because I think it was kind of just a font.
The way that it comes in.
Just aerial.
Yeah.
Maybe they redid the UI and it'll look really sparse and clean in like context or something.
Right.
I just want to play this.
Screenshot mode?
Oh my god, yeah. Screenshot mode.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Holy shit.
Here, I think I have a clip of how You Died used to look. Let's bring it up really quick. Just give me a sec.
I feel like the font is taller.
The thing is like, do I do what Brad did and play like Demon's Souls right now, or do I just wait?
Wait it out.
I'm waiting, dude.
Either way, you win, because you'll be playing.
Yeah, either way, you win. Yeah.
Oh, God.
God, those guys killed me 3,000 times.
Yo, mind flayers.
Yeah, those guys are insane.
Yeah.
The wipe of the...
Whoop. Dead.
Classic,
yeah, like
dude.
The white
lines above it and below look more stylized, maybe.
Little sharp edges on.
Well, and the word fades in first in the
right.
Fades in white first in the new one, and it doesn't have that text underneath it.
$70, €80,
€80, dude.
We're gonna get those arguments back,
dude. Like, that's so much money. You really need to pause and think when you invest in a game.
Yeah,
it's gonna be like, yo, how long is this? Oh, it's not 30 hours. Like, no thanks.
Oh yeah, it's just like.
There is more variation in those prices too. You know, like Spider-Man 50, and then Sackboy 60. So.
Well, but does that mean that Miles Morales would have been 39 in the current pricing structure and 50 is the new 39? So, like, all those middle games are all going to be 50 now?
I think so.
Yep. Who knows?
Yeah, and what will the PC price be? Will this be 70 as well on PC?
I bet it
Oh, yeah, that'd be weird.
I feel like it would have to be.
Yeah.
It'll go on sale, like, 2 weeks later, though.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
Oh, it doesn't come out on the same day on PC? Then it might be 60 or something.
Oh, it's not day and day on PC?
That's what chat just said.
Oh, shit.
Oh, let me check that out.
I'll buy on PC later then.
Goaty Souls.
Goaty Souls. What was after that? My brain stopped working after that.
Fortnite.
Fortnite.
Skip that.
And then the PlayStation Plus collection, which is interesting.
Real cool news, yeah.
Sort of half Game Pass. You get a collection of PS4 titles that you can download on the PS5.
Which I think we're all
PlayStation subscription.
But I mean,
those have all been
a
PlayStation Plus games in the past, I believe.
And I need to know.
I mean, not
the benefits and the stats and the specs of all that.
Well, not Persona 5 either.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you mean how they're going to be upgraded?
Yeah, I need to. I need to know.
But the thing is like,
there
are going to be so many people that, you know, either didn't have a PS4 or missed out on those games, and it's like all of that is available at launch on top of the PS5 games. Like, that's a lot of great shit to play.
Yeah.
Just straight up.
Apparently that Demon's Souls trailer got upgraded. Taken down, so people are thinking the PC bit might be an error or might get removed for now.
Oh man.
Oh, so you think maybe PC might not even be a thing?
A new version of the trailer is going to go up with a download the demo now on Steam.
Oh,
who knows?
You almost had me. I was like in the middle of like trying to get another trailer. I'm like, wait, what? Where's this trailer?
Yeah, it's all the PlayStation Hits games.
It's like, dude, just give us 1-1. 1-1 demo.
What was next? After the PlayStation
I think it
Plus
was
thing?
Fortnite?
After that was the price.
Whoa! Ray Tracing overview.
What are you doing, Dominic? What are you doing?
For Devil May Cry.
God of War announcement?
And then the what God of War after? Ragnarok.
Oh, gosh. That's.
I mean, God of War was hype, but there's really nothing.
Yeah, that was Elder Scrolls just the logo. 6, like, sure.
Yeah, but I mean,
but
2021
date,
crazy.
Dude, that's crazy.
It's that crazy.
Ooh. I think that's
They've
so crazy.
They've been working on it since.
Those reflections.
Elder Scrolls the first 6 game... was 4 years ago, and we still don't have a date for that.
Yeah, that's Bethesda. These guys, like, they knew they were making 2, you know, as evidenced by many things in 1, so.
Yeah. Yeah, and the difficulty of making the first game was figuring out what the heck it was going to be, even.
Right.
You know, it's like, now they have a direction, and now they have kind of, you know, somewhat of a template to go off of, as well as probably a lot of that story written from the get-go.
Mm-hmm.
And so it really is just about, okay, building a new world and new abilities, and...
so that was with it off.
And taking advantage of PS5.
Such rage racing, dude.
Yep.
Look at that.
But even the pavement is way better.
Yeah. Yeah. And you can just see, like, just the specs on the pavement, too.
Took me a second to realize you meant specs as in, like, particles, not specs. S-P-E-C.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Particles.
I was like, yeah, I mean, it's a good machine.
Sometimes the hype, the bundles, the words, jumbles up the words.
Oh, no, it was my hype making me miss him. Ray tracing, dude.
Oh, dude, time to do a DMC5 ray tracing run. Head off, man. Let's go.
It's great.
It looks better, but sometimes ray tracing scenes feel like they're darker.
Whoa.
Sometimes it makes it lighter than you want.
Sometimes it makes it look washed out, too.
Yeah.
Chat's saying it's 4K 30. 120 is 1080p.
Wow.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah, that
makes huge sense drop. But yeah,
gotta pay for that K.
But I mean, you have the option, right?
It's exactly.
Like you can't get 120.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, as someone who's buying all this stuff and not getting a 4K TV or monitor anytime soon, I'm totally fine with high frame rate 1080p games.
Getting a 4K TV now, finally, probably.
Legendary Dark Knight.
Yeah, so they're really showing like how crazy the enemies will get on Legendary Dark Knight and difficulty, which is awesome.
All right, there you go.
It'll be like a Devil May Cry Musou kind of.
We did it. We're on the other side. We know how much we need to spend.
Yeah.
We don't know when we get to spend it. But
tomorrow.
Tomorrow, sometime.
Apparently, Keely does not have a time yet, but yeah.
Keely hasn't called me yet, but when he does, I'll let you know.
Okay, good.
I don't want to wake up early, but I might have to for all this.
I mean, we're going to have to wake up early anyways. Well, yeah, I guess you guys don't have to, but
I'm not waking up for that.
Some of us are going to wake up early.
Yeah, some of you guys.
To react to Monster Hunter tomorrow?
To react to Monster Hunter tomorrow.
Hell yeah, bro.
React to the announcement of the DLSS Switch to...
Dragon's Dogma launching on Switch? Switch
Pro? Yeah, Switch.
I mean, Dragon's Dogma is already on Switch.
Bam.
I know, New Mist looks cool. Is it Oculus only? I prefer the Index.
The New Mist?
Yeah.
I didn't think that was Oculus only, was it?
I don't know. Sound Constant said on Oculus.
Yeah, I guess some new stuff dropped. It's a big day so far.
Yeah,
it's nuts.
Today was E3.
What's the news today? Thank you to the entire crew of the Allies.
This is good stuff. Yeah, wow.
All eight on deck to get the date, get the price. And it's fun because I think we all got a dog in this race. You know, I think like we kind of like everybody on the panel is like, ooh, like,
yeah,
a lot
of
somebody said
that
clearly the game we're all excited for is, and like we would all shout out different stuff. So, like,
yeah,
that's a good sign.
Best of the
Horizon
world.
2 is a PS4 game now. Just got up to some process that.
Like earth shattering. Announcements here from games to €80 for price, $70 for DualSense.
Not bad.
It's tough because it's called
industry changing announcements. I cannot stress enough, like the price of games is that's a big deal.
Yeah, what letter grade would we give this?
The thing I'm still hung up on is that we like it's over and we're like, oh, neat. And then it's like, okay, here come everybody else to tell you what just happened. And it's like, I don't understand why the event can't do that. I don't understand why it's like, here's all this is really good news. It's like, why the hell do you keep good news out of your... Why is Eves being like,
could
put the
way,
apology
though.
In the video. It's just, you know, videos. And it's like, yeah, it doesn't take that long to render and upload.
Right, like even the PlayStation, the Plus subscription thing, or the collection... Like the trailer really said all you need to know, but there is something that like when it's just like titles on the screen and not somebody like saying, and this will come and with your current PlayStation, like it just, there's something different about it when it's not spoken sometimes.
There's still so many questions about that. I have 100 questions.
About like,
I'd probably go high.
Well, number
B+,
one.
B or B plus for me.
Yeah, number B+, one. Probably.
There's some crazy news that dropped.
It was honestly an A for me. Like I can't wait to play this stuff at launch. Like I feel like I'll have so many options of things that I want to play equally and will last me a long time. Like, yeah, I can't wait. I'm pumped through the roof.
Not saying at launch, I think is a miss for some of these things. Like saying you could have just said that.
That's
even if you want to wait on when you're telling the date. Later in the thing, say at launch in your trailer.
A plus even. an A probably, just because I still have questions, but an A because the only thing I ever want from one of these is a huge reveal in the very beginning and the very end. And we had that with Final Fantasy. Mm-hmm. We had that with God of War. And then in the middle, they hit some of my favorite franchises from Resident Evil to Demon Souls. So... there's nothing I could have asked for more. So that's an A. That's an easy A.
Has been removed. Yeah.
All of them, all versions.
It sounds like there's a mistake about the language, a verbiage used for confusion over whether there's a PC version or not. Actually.
Weird. Yeah. Okay.
Ben, I think you touched on something too. With. You want to play this right now. And I remember leading up to next gen for a while, you were kind of like, you know, I don't really feel there's so much now on current gen and so much coming like Cyberpunk that I haven't had really the itch and the passion and the fever to like need next gen. And after watching this showcase now, like with Miles Morales and Demon's Souls specifically, it's like, I need this at launch, next gen hype.
A lot of the next gen stuff in the way that they've been talking about it has been, it gives the sensation of this will be cool eventually. Mm-hmm. But this is the first time where I'm like, this is going to be amazing really, really soon. And we get to see it in action. Mm-hmm. And that does a lot, right? And it wasn't just that. It also made the future exciting, right? Like Final Fantasy 16, yeah. Right? And opening the show with that, I think the way things were ordered here really affected how the event hit me, right? Like if they opened with Fortnite, I'd probably feel a little bit different than I do with the way that they structured yeah. it. So
still saying holiday for Miles is that could be like December 28th. Yeah. You know, like that could be way after launch. Like,
but no, they like, said launch.
I think they were just saying that so they didn't spoil the release date of the console till the end of the presentation.
But yeah. They did say later. Okay.
Yeah, they said launch.
Yeah, it says launch in the email.
Cool.
All right.
Yeah.
Also, Destruction All-Stars is launched, which they didn't do anything but put in the montage.
I confirmed on Twitter. Okay.
So November 12th, I'm putting up my Christmas decorations to get in the Miles Morales.
Like, yeah, that is going to be a Christmas game. Christmas game. Yeah, you're right.
Man.
Cool.
Yeah.
Sweet.
I'm going to be obsessed over Final Fantasy 16 forever now.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Do some research. Get back to us.
Oh, yeah.
You salute some stuff. Blood, you sniff some stuff. We will reconvene tomorrow.
Last little bit. Are you guys bummed we didn't see the UI, the interface, the PlayStation 5 interface? Does that mark it down?
I like not to be much. Surprised.
I wouldn't say marks it down, but I would like to have seen it.
Cool. Yeah,
I don't know how different it will be, or you know, whether even when it comes out, if the PS4 will update to match it, you know, because mm-hmm. that's kind of how the Xbox strategy is, right? Is to just try to have a similar UI across platforms, but Sony hasn't exactly done that. So I'm curious to see what
they do. For me, it's all about the startup sound. Like, will the orchestra return?
Right. Yeah.
And then
kind of the same situation as Brad, where it would be nice to see it, but I'm just so all about the games that I think I would take more of a focus on games than spending time mm-hmm. looking at the UI. In a presentation like this, I definitely think you can do like its own separate video or a PlayStation blog post or something that can cover those aspects pretty sufficiently.
Oh, you know what it would have been a slick is if instead of those weird random graphic interludes in each one of those interludes, it would just be navigating the UI to the next trailer or something.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah,
that would be nice. Cool. Don,
yeah. Maybe the launch presentation will happen.
Yeah.
Peace. And then I don't know if we talked about it enough, the Discverse Digital, guys, what are your final thoughts on that? 500, 400, you like the price, you like the options, are any of you getting disc based?
I'm absolutely getting disc.
I'm getting disc. Okay. I feel like I have to. Okay.
Whatever I get, I have to. Yeah. At whatever point okay. digital. In the future.
Whoa,
sure.
I thought you guys were going the other way.
No, we talked about
the
it.
Only digital
disc.
One.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's disc. Ultra HD Blu-ray, but I think
I'll probably go disc. I don't know though.
I think that they really are taking
my disc drive doesn't work in my PS4 Pro, so I admittedly haven't either. Used it for a long time, so I can live without it. But it's like to say what I know is going to happen in a generation of gaming is very dumb.
I just think it's going to break,
pay up, and just increase my options.
But yeah, I just like that price. Most likely that they are taking more of a hit on that 400. You know that you know the price differentiator there isn't that it's 400 and then they've like put up this mm-hmm. extra tax if you want a disc. It's more like no, it's probably 500 and they're gonna slash it as much as they possibly can to get you to go all digital because they're gonna make more money in the long run. The more people,
they make more money,
and just to have a more competitive place in the marketplace by offering next gen at that tiered prices.
The only thing that concerns me is still we don't know the noise of the consoles. You know, what if the based version
that's a good point.
Is somehow that's way it. Louder? Yeah. Like, these are the types of
possible.
Digital Foundry articles I need.
Oh my god, the noise of the PS4 drives me nuts.
Hope it doesn't have like coils that sound like train braking. I don't know if you saw one of the 3080 tests from the reviews. They posted a video of how it sounded. and like it maxed out, and it's like sounds like a train breaking. I was like, oh my god. Like, yeah. Yeah, need those silent fans, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
All right.
Woo.
Cool.
Thanks, everyone.
I'll be on standby, guys. Call me whenever.
Yeah.
All your pre-orders.
3080.
All right, Huber, I'm driving over to your apartment right now.
Nice. Cool. Thanks for setting this up, Damiani.
No problem.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.